have a tough time dating. Y'all know I'm trans, right? Y'all figured that out already? You bunch of... Look at you. You bunch of LA detectives. Y'all are like, of course I know. I'm from Kansas, not from Mars. I can tell. Now, the weird thing is, I wasn't trans before I got the vaccine. Fucking Johnson & Johnson, I swear to God. One shot my ass.
Can I just say a sentence out loud that I kind of can't believe I'm gonna say out loud? It's 2022. We're doing stuff right now in 2022 that we never would have been able to predict. We never would have thought that this is where the world would go. We're out here doing, we're repping vaccines like we're in gangs and shit. We're on the street like, Pfizer, motherfucker, what's good? Who you with, Moderna, who you with? We look at people with Johnson & Johnson like they have prepaid cell phones, we're like, like, damn, how people live like this? This is crazy. If you got the Johnson & Johnson on the first round, that is the most cis, straight, white man thing you can do. Johnson & Johnson is the most shampoo and conditioner combined shit you can do.
But it's nice to be here. Nice to be back in New York. You know, I don't live here no more. I live in London, and yeah. I like it there, but it's nice to be back in New York, and you know, always a lot of love for me here. Sometimes too much love, you know. The other day I went to a restaurant, and there was a line. Everybody was checking their COVID passes and stuff, and then I walked up, and the guy was like, "Oh, Aziz, you're all good, bro. Just come on in." And I was like, "No, no, 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 no. Please check my pass. I'm not out here trying to have dinner with Kyrie Irving and Nicki Minaj. I got an extra 10 seconds, please." We're all pretty close, man. You guys had to show your COVID pass, right? Yeah. Or your easily obtainable fake COVID pass. Who designed these things, man? Can we get the squad that did the McDonald's Monopoly pieces? Those have so much more security. There's like holograms and shit. You go into a McDonald's, they're like, "This isn't Pennsylvania Avenue. Get the shit out of here." COVID pass team was like, "White paper, black lines, I think we're done, Jim."
Yeah, COVID is some bullshit, man, you know. Fucks talking about take the shot. I don't know what the fuck to do. That shit is, they're trying to scare you with the shit. Go ahead and take it. Oh, got a pill now. Ah! I went on and got it. I said, fuck it, I went on and got it. Yeah, I went on and got it. When they start talking about cutting my shit off Netflix, I say, "Here, where you gonna hit it at? Put it in." I say, "Hit me in the ass with it, hit me." I thought I had it, I thought I had it. I went to the doctor and he said, "That ain't what I said." I said, "What'd you say?" He said, "I told you you tested positive for cocaine on the 19th. I said, "Oh, I didn't hear you. I didn't know what you said. All I heard was 19. See, niggas don't want to take the shot. The best way to get niggas to take that shot is put it in flavors. That motherfucker popping that pineapple Moderna, nigga? Shit. That watermelon Pfizer? Nigga, yeah, man, I'm on my 9th shot, man. You know, they got the mango coming out next month, man."
You know, I was in London, and I got one shot of AstraZeneca. Then I had to come to LA for something, and I called my doctor. I was like, "Should I just get the Johnson & Johnson one?" He's like, "Yeah, go ahead and get it so you're fully back." So then I got Johnson & Johnson, and then recently I got a booster. I got a Pfizer. So I got a lot going on. I'm like one of those DJ Khaled songs with way too many features. Another one. People go in on the folks that don't want the vaccine, though, right? Who's that guy? A football player? Aaron Rodgers? Yeah. What do you think about that guy? Fuck him! People hate that guy. Like, he's a fucking idiot! It's like, all right, calm down. He's a football player. He read some articles. He got skeptical. He did some research. Are you stunned he came to the wrong conclusion? Did you really think he was gonna crack the case? Did you think Fauci was gonna be out there like, oh, I just got off the phone with Aaron Rodgers? This poor guy. It's like we're all in high school and we're making fun of the quarterback for doing bad on the science test. You're a dummy, Aaron. You're a dummy. You don't know anything, do you? You're a dum-dum. This guy makes a living getting hit in the head. Can we cut him a break? I guess he did kind of lie, right? They're like, are you vaccinated? He was like, I'm immunized. My doctor gave me some powders from Jamba Juice. And he did come off a little arrogant in some of those interviews and stuff, right? You know, he was out there, he's like, oh, you know, I'm a critical thinker. Oh, no. Was he, like, running the scientific method? Question, should I get the vaccine? Hypothesis, I don't think so. Data gathering, listening to some podcasts and talking to a few sketchy doctors. Conclusion, no way, Jose. I don't think he's an idiot, though, okay? I don't think him, Nicki Minaj, any of these people are idiots. I'm not here to say that, okay? And I just think they're trapped in a different algorithm than you are. You know what I mean by that? And if you're calling them idiots and stuff, you're trapped in another algorithm. I know everything you're gonna say about everything. Oh, all these dummies are just taking horse medicine, ha ha. All right, well, technically, humans can take that medicine, all right? Yes, there's nothing showing it actually helps with COVID, but when you just say they're taking horse medicine, it pushes them further away. I don't know, man. We just gotta figure out some way to have some empathy. We're all kind of just trapped in our own little world. And unless we figure out how to talk to each other in real life again, it doesn't even matter what the problem is. I don't know what the answer is. Maybe click on some of the stuff they click on for a few days. See what's going on. Don't go too hard, though. End of the week, you'll be out there like, Fauci's a pedophile.
It was crazy. Like, we had to wear a mask to save lives. Like, that's what we needed to do, right? And, like, when the people were dying, I was so angry when I would see someone's nose. And it was always an older man's nose. I see y'all. Y'all didn't give a fuck. Bill, Bob, James, whoever the fuck you are. I saw it. I was so mad. I was like, put your nose away. You remember a few years ago when guys were just taking their dicks out at work? We were like, nobody wants to see your dick. This time I was like, nobody wants to see your nose. These guys turned me into a Karen. I was tattletailing at Whole Foods. I'm like, his nose is out. He is by the rotisserie chickens. That is not okay.
I gotta be honest, though, you know, I saw a lot of you youngsters didn't wear masks, and I got upset at first, but then I did the math. I understand why you didn't wear them. You know what I mean? You knew you were gonna survive, right? You went to college, you bought the dream, you left with the debt, and there was no jobs. So you played the only card you had. Get COVID and breathe on somebody older with the corner office. That's what you do. All right? Power is not given away. It has to be taken. And people have to die, historically speaking. People have to go. You know what did amaze me during all of this was the amount of shit that doctors got from non-doctors. slash complete fucking morons. People who had to go to summer school. According to my internet research, if you take a little bleach, vitamin D, and aspirin, the people are like listening to them. Like my favorite heckle doctors got from people was like, dude, what's the last thing they even cured? What? Fucking polio? It's like, no, HPV. They just came out with the vaccine for HPV. No more warts on your dick. We should be carrying these people around on our shoulders. Thank you for not having to make me go down to the doctor and be like, that's not a birthmark, is it? Or even worse, you're too shy to go, so you try to do self-surgery with a frozen Bud Light can. Stick it on there, freeze it up! Bud Light, one of the big sponsors of this comedy time. Now, they say that, you know, what is the last thing they cured? How about AIDS? Dude, AIDS was gonna kill everybody. You get it from fucking, it was over. Now look at it. Now you can get it, they give you one pill. It doesn't even show up on a test. You can go out and bang somebody, no condom, they don't even get it. According to my internet research. Don't listen to me, but I think that that's what I overheard in a bar.
Right, there's a real spirit of innovation here, right? It's that same energy that allows you to innovate to the point where you get the iPhone 13 Max Pro. Is the 12 okay? 12 is amazing, but fuck it, keep going, come on. You can put some more lenses on this thing, there's still some more surface area. Come on. It's the same energy that allows you to create a miracle mRNA vaccine in under a year. Yeah. That works and then refuse to take it. That is the most American shit ever. America is like, the whole world is in trouble. Let's use everything we've ever learned, our entire knowledge base, every resource at our disposal, every immigrant who ever got a PhD, every local-born PhD student, let's combine forces and create this miracle mRNA vaccine in under a year. And we did it, and it fucking works, and fuck you! We're not gonna take it! Fuck you! We're not taking that shit! We're not taking that! You take it! We're not taking it, you take it! Oh, what? Oh, what? You want it? Oh, you want it? Well, fuck that, we're not gonna give it to ya! You rather throw it in the river! You rather throw it in the river, go suck it up from the river, suck it. Suck my dick. Fuck you and fuck us. Fuck you and fuck us. Oh, what? What? Does it work? Oh my god, it works like a charm! It's like a 90% efficacy, it blows all simulations out of the water, but fuck that shit, we're not taking it. Fuck you and fuck us. That is the most American shit ever.
I grew up watching scary movies. Now, I love zombie movies, right? And there's always that scene, yeah, where you find out, oh my God, there's zombies. And it's never just one zombie, it's like 30 zombies. And I would watch that scene in every movie and think, that's unrealistic. How would they let it get so bad? Right? Because if I ever see one zombie, I'm killing the zombie. But to get to 30? How do we do that? And then I started thinking, oh, you know why? It's because we never show that scene in the movie where the assholes are walking around like, it's my right to get bit by a zombie. Ooh. To get bit by a zombie. You're not supposed to pick how you die, stupid.
It's the last thing they cured. Do you know what fake legs looked like when I was a kid? Huh? First of all, there was only one color. It was like Band-Aid color, and everybody knew you had a fake leg, and you were fucking walking down the street, and you've got a fake leg. What do you think happened? Motorcycle accident. Fell down a flight of stairs. Got impatient with a wood chipper, right? Everybody knew you had a fake leg. Now, if you have fake legs, you're not allowed to compete with people with real legs in the Olympics. because not having legs is now more of an advantage than having real legs. Doctors make better legs than God. All right, your calves and your feet flopping around are no match for a couple of sickles. These people just skiing down the fucking street. You get them by some train tracks that go downhill, you're never gonna see them again. I enjoyed people being their own doctors. I loved it. Good. Kill yourselves. Kill yourselves. There's too many of us. It's fantastic.
Everyone's always asking me to use my platform, right? Use your platform to spread awareness. Spread it. Spread awareness of vaccines. Ronnie, if you don't use your platform to spread awareness of vaccines, do you know anti-vaxxers might not take the vaccine? And they could die. What am I missing? You're telling me if I do absolutely nothing, I can make humanity better in 1 to 2 generations? I mean, the public utility to effort ratio on that graph is just out of control. Like, if you calculate efficiency on that curve, at this point, it would be socially irresponsible for me to tell people about vaccines. All right? Just mathematically speaking. All right? Like, this is the miraculous technological era that we live in right now. Okay? Within 3 months of this shit breaking out, in March 2020, they decoded the genome of the virus. Yeah! They decoded it! You're like, yo, everyone, look, we found it. We found the enemy. Everybody, look, we got it right here. Look, it's A-A-A-B-B-B-B-B-G-G-G-G-A-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B-B- these idiots on Facebook demanding evidence. So what's the evidence? Is that evidence? Is that right here? Yeah, we got it. We found the exact sequence of proteins and amino acids. The fuck is this shit? Oh yeah, right, you decoded a genome. Oh yeah, you expect us to believe you decoded a genome. And that's what it looks like. These shitty Scrabble letters. Yeah, I can decode genomes too. Anyone can decode genomes. Watch me decode genomes on my keyboard all day. All these fucking D-average students who are in the back of the classroom. Their entire academic career, they were in the back of the class. Stay the fuck in the back. Don't come to the front during a pandemic because you figured out how to start a podcast. Stay the fuck in the back with your D-average mouth where you belong. You had every opportunity to prove yourself academically and you failed or were mediocre at best at every level. Why the fuck should we listen to you about anything? Let the nerds lead. Yeah. That's what the nerds are for.